Hi, welcome back to the Cloudflare Stream series, where I share with you everything you need to know to get started with using Cloudflare Stream. In this video, we'll cover how to enable live streaming, record and replay your streams, and even simulcast your videos to other platforms like Twitch and YouTube. With that, let's get right into it.
To start a live stream, you can use the stream dashboard or the API. For this demo, I'll be using the dashboard. Now on Cloudflare's dashboard, head over to the stream tab and underneath that, select live input. In order for us to broadcast or create a live stream, we would need to first create a live input. Click the create live input button and on this page, you'll be asked for a few options. First, you'll be asked to enter a name for this live input. I'll call that stream demo. Then you have other options you can select or uncheck. The first one being live playback and recording. What this means is immediately your live stream ends, an instant replay recording will be created for you to either use using the stream player or any custom player of your choice that supports HLS or Dash. The other option is required sign URLs. Now, this is a good option to check if you like to restrict access to certain users by requiring a signed URL token to watch the live stream. And then the next option is an option to automatically delete the recording. So after a period of time, if you don't want to keep the recordings anymore, you can delete them after a number of days. The minimum days you can set is a 30-day deletion period. There are also optional settings to enable. One of them is called metadata. Now, this is useful if you need to add a key value pair that will appear in the API, maybe because you're using it to store IDs for your database. This is not required for this demo, so I'll skip it. And then you also have the call command for running or creating a live input using the API. So if you decide you want to use the API to programmatically create a live input, then you can copy this over to your terminal and enter your token before running the command. Otherwise, we can just create live input directly from the dashboard. So I'll go ahead and create the live input by clicking this button. Now we see a new page where we have a live input ID listed, the options that we checked from the previous page, as well as an input status with a value set as disconnected. Now, what does this mean? It means that you're not connecting the stream to any input at the moment. And in order for you to set up this live stream, you'd need to set up a RTMPS or SRT input connection to a live streaming platform, in which case you can either decide to use OBS or Streamlabs application. Now let's set that up so that we can enable the live stream. Now we need to connect this live input to a streaming application. For this demo, I'll be using an application called Streamlabs. Now, what we need to do is copy over the connection information, so the RTMPS URL and the RTMPS stream key in the streaming application of choice. So let's head over to Streamlabs. Over at Streamlabs, I will go to the settings page and under stream, select custom streaming server. So I'll copy the URL, paste it here, and also copy the stream key, which is the second key, and also paste it over here. Once that is done, I'll click on done. And now for my stream, what I have is I have a webcam capture that you can see, and I'm also sharing my screen. So with this, I can go live. So to go live, I just need to click this button here. Now the live stream has started. It's going to take a few minutes for it to reflect in my stream dashboard. So I'm going to go back to stream dashboard and see exactly what's happening now. So you can see this input status has changed to connected. It's going to take a few minutes for it to pop up here. Great, now we see that our live stream is now connected to our live input. Now what you can do here is you can either decide to embed this in a different application. Maybe you have like a web application where you would like to use this live stream. So you can copy over the embed link in your app or use the HLS manifest URL. So if you're using a custom player, you can also use this to add in your web application. Great, so we've enabled live stream. You also have the option of simulcasting your live stream to other platforms. Now you can add additional output to your live video. For example, if you like to stream this video directly to YouTube, Twitch, or Facebook Live, all you need to do is add an additional output by clicking on the Create Output button. Now, depending on the service you choose to use, they can either be using the RTMPS protocol or the SRT protocol. For YouTube Live, if you want to create a live stream, YouTube will give you a URL and a key, a stream key. So all you need to do is enter that here. The same applies if you're using Twitch or any other platform. By entering that here, your content that you're live streaming will automatically begin streaming to those platforms. So whether YouTube or Twitch. So now we are still live. If you remember from the earlier setup that we did, I enabled live playback and recording. Now what this means is if I end the stream now, I would immediately get a video created from the live input. So an instant replay or recording of the video of the live stream that I have, which I can then use for other purposes, maybe sending it to the viewers or putting it up on another media platform. So let's go ahead and end the stream. I'll click on the end stream button here and head over to the stream dashboard. It will take a little bit for you to see, so you can see that the input status has changed to disconnected. After a while, you see that the status of the video changed from live to ready, meaning that you have access to the recording of the video that you can either watch or reuse for other purposes. Here's the video link if you'd like to watch it live or embed it in a different platform. One additional thing I'll add is you might have a use case where you'd like to use your own custom ingest domain instead of the default one used by Cloudflare Stream, live.cloudflare.com. Now, to do this, you would need to add a custom ingest domain. To do that, let's head back to the Live Input page and then click the settings icon. So there are two steps you need to do. So first you need to add the domain here. So the domain that you like to use as your default domain. And then at your DNS provider, add a CNAME record that points to live.cloudflare.com. If your DNS provider is Cloudflare, then this step is done automatically for you. Once that is completed, your custom domain would now be used as a custom live input domain.
That's it for this video on going live with Cloudflare Stream. If you have any comments or questions, please leave it in the description box below. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.